Monsieur le Président,
Mr. Chairman,
honorable délégué,
delegates,
à l'entame de mon propos, permettez-moi,
at the outset,
le Président,
allow me, Mr. Chairman,
de vous adresser
to address to you on behalf of our delegation our warm congratulations on your election to the chairmanship of the 22nd session of the Conference of States Parties. I am convinced that thanks to your experience and to your skills, the work of this session will be crowned with success. To this end, I would like to assure you of the support of our delegation as well as our availability. I'd like to take this opportunity to also congratulate your predecessor, Ambassador Christoph Israng from the Federal Republic of Germany, for the efforts which he had deployed during his term of office. I would also like to thank the Director General, as well as the staff of the OPCW for all of the work that you've carried out in implementing the convention. Mr. Chairman, our delegation would like to support the declaration made by Ambassador Bruce Kaluane from South Africa on behalf of the Africa Group. Mr. Chairman, honorable delegates, this session of the Conference of States Parties is taking place in a very particular context for the OPCW. It's taking place during our 20th anniversary year. And this anniversary is therefore a time when we may review all of our activities, but also we may renew our commitment to a world free of chemical weapons and free of the threat of their resurgence. Strengthened by this conviction, Côte d'Ivoire notes with satisfaction the elimination of and the destruction of close to 96% of the chemical weapon stockpiles that were declared in the world. To this end, I would like to welcome the destruction of the Category 1 Libyan chemical weapons from Libya, and I would like to congratulate the Russian Federation for having completed the destruction program for their chemical weapons stockpile. I'd like to take this opportunity to call on all states to destroy all of the existing chemical weapons stockpiles throughout the world. I remain convinced that for us to be able to achieve this noble goal of a world without chemical weapons, which is considered a weapon of mass destruction, the CWC must be universal. And this is why I would like to invite all those states that are not yet members of the convention to accede to it as soon as possible. In the same light, I'm very happy to reaffirm that the use of chemical weapons cannot be justified, no matter the circumstances. Such atrocities are completely unacceptable, and their perpetrators must be brought to justice. Mr. Chairman,
cette vision.
The vision that we have of a world free of chemical weapons must go along with the promotion of international cooperation to the benefit of our states parties, and in particular through an effective mechanism for transfer of technologies so as to be able to use chemistry only for peaceful purposes. And this is why I welcome the renewal of the Program for Africa program, which is now in its fourth phase. To this end, I would also like to indicate that my country, Côte d'Ivoire,
depuis son adhésion
since
à la
we have acceded to the convention,
travaille sans relâche
has been
à la
working
mise en œuvre de ce
tirelessly to implement this treaty.
L'autorité nationale
the national authority
a élaboré les outils juridiques
has developed
mise au point
legal
des
instruments.
Et mécanismes de contrôle
it has developed procedures and mechanisms for internal follow-up and monitoring. It has carried out an awareness program on chemical weapons and has hosted several events with the customs authorities and with various stakeholders in the chemical sector. Based on these advances, the national authority received the responsibility from our government for related conventions, and in particular, the conventions on biological weapons, on nuclear weapons, as well as on explosives. This is not only a national commitment, because we are also working in the regional area. Côte d'Ivoire is working to help extend the reach of the OPCW, in particular by helping our neighbors who are asking for our know-how. Moreover, Côte d'Ivoire
in 2015
hosted the meeting of the national authorities of the ECOWAS countries so as to create a pool of resources for any response needed against any chemical attack or accident to help to respond to the terrorist threat in Africa, which we are seeing more and more. In 2016, my country organized a regional customs course, and we are always ready to host any meetings with the OPCW. All of these actions and all of these substantial progress that we've made has all been possible thanks to the technical support of the OPCW and the financial support of those donor countries, which I would like, on behalf of our government, to thank. I hope that the OPCW's program for Africa will be continued and in a more effective way in cooperating with those states that are concerned, with the African Union, and with the regional economic communities. While thanking those states that have made voluntary contributions to this program, I would hope also that this program would be financed by a line item in the ordinary budget of the organization. Mr. Chairman, I would like to congratulate Ambassador Momar Diop from Senegal, the chair of the Working Group on Terrorism, and to Ambassador Maria Teresa Infante of Chile, the chair of the Working Group on Non-State Actors, for the excellent work that they've been carrying out, and we would like to recommend that they continue in the same vein. We would also like to congratulate Ambassadors Bruce Colohane from South Africa and Sabine Nolke from Canada, who are co-chairs of the Working Group on the Future Priorities of the Organization. And we would also like to encourage them to continue their work in the same vein as well. Mr. Chairman, the Executive Council at its 86th session recommended by consensus to the Conference of States Parties that Ambassador Fernando Arias of Spain be nominated as Director General of the OPCW starting on 25 July 2018. On behalf of our delegation, I would like to warmly congratulate Ambassador Arias and wish him success in his new mission. In conclusion, Mr. Chairman, I would like to wish that our work be crowned with success and that this declaration be considered as an official document from the conference. Thank you.